And now for a different perspective, and for that we turned to Zbigniew Brzezinski, former National Security Advisor to President Jimmy Carter and the author of Strategic Vision, America and the Crisis of Global Power. Dr. Brzezinski, welcome to the program.
It's nice to be with you.
So, do you share Senator McCain's skepticism that the Russians are sincere in this whole effort?
I wouldn't say skepticism. I do have some uncertainties, because after all, what the Russians have proposed is merely a generalized outline of an approach, how to deal with the weapons, chemical weapons, that the Syrians are expected to yield. But that, of course, raises a lot of additional questions. And I don't know how far the Russians are prepared to go with us, but it opens the door to something that Senator McCain mentioned, and with which I actually agree, even though on some other issues we do not. Namely, that what is needed is really a UN-sponsored effort. UN-sponsored effort. What does that mean? It means, first of all, the principal powers with veto rights in the UN. That means not only the Russians or us, also the Chinese, for example, who can be a very important player here, given their stake in a stable Middle East. And I think the senator was correct in saying this will take time. And we have to be patient and persistent.
But isn't the administration's position that they've tried the United Nations, that Russia has vetoed, the Chinese have not been cooperative, and that's why this new opportunity, the opening that just came up in the last few days, is the one hope right now of avoiding a military action?
That is correct. And this is why we have to pursue it. And if we pursue it seriously and systematically, we will eventually establish whether the Russians are serious or not. My own personal guess is that they are serious up to a point, in that the Russians are beginning to realize that we are on the brink of a region-wide explosion. And if that occurs, not only will we be adversely affected, but eventually they will be adversely affected. The Caucasus is just on the point of explosion.
This is the western part of Russia.
Yes, well, southwestern.
Right.
And the Russians have made a very major investment on Putin personally in the Olympics. And that could go up in smoke.
So you're saying that if the Russians are now looking at a situation that they think it could blow up, so do you think this is a way to avert that happening? Do you think that this effort to work with the Russians could produce a result that could lead to success?
I think there is the potential for it. And in any case, we shouldn't discount it in advance without trying to see if there is some reality to it. I happen to believe, and I have said this many times on this issue, and the senator and I have disagreed publicly, that an expansion of the conflict to include the United States would be very disadvantageous to the United States. And I think the senator now agrees with that, because he says we don't want any boots on the ground. If we use force, we'll only use air power. Well, air power is not going to win this conflict. If we are going to be decisive in asserting an outcome, we would have to step in.
Isn't the signal the administration is sending, though, Dr. Brzezinski, that if this effort with the Russians doesn't work out, the president is prepared to go in with a limited military strike to punish the Syrians?
That's right. It's a limited military strike, which means it really doesn't have an impact on the outcome of the conflict. But if the conflict in the meantime escalates, we can be sucked into it. And in any case, the region becomes so volatile that even the global economy begins to be affected.
So my question to you is, if this effort Secretary Kerry is making with the Russians does not bear fruit, what should happen next?
I think, first of all, we shouldn't really publicly commit ourselves to something different on the assumption that it will not bear fruit. It's worth exploring. And I think we ought to approach it somewhat differently. For example, we have taken the stand that we and our friends are engaged and have a common point of view. Who are these friends that are so visible? Britain and France. Can we overlook their role in the region and their standing in the region? They're hated in the region. They're the formal colonial powers, imperialist powers. We want to engage, we should be engaging, the European Union as a whole, which has a stand and a point of view, which is not for military action, incidentally. We should also seek to engage some major Asian powers who are very dependent on continued flow of oil from the Middle East, and particularly China, which has a veto in the UN Security Council. China is not linked, at the hip to Russia. China has its own interests, And I think it could be a constructive player.
And you're saying the United States has not been doing this?
That's exactly right.
And are you confident that that's what the administration will be prepared to do?
I can't speak for the administration. I have talked to some members of it, but I really can't even speculate publicly on that. I think it's a reasonable course of action, and I think it should be explored and pursued. And if we become engaged with the Russians, I think the dynamic of that process will have that effect.
Do you think that right now the administration has the right larger strategy in the region?
I think it's moving in that direction. I have been a critic of our position so far because I have felt all along that we have been articulating either demands or red lines, but we haven't been pursuing a strategy. I think circumstances now are beginning to force us to really think strategically.
And do you believe the president's doing that? He's received some praise for his address last night, but he's certainly also been criticized.
Well, the address was to some extent triggered by the commitment to use force. And I think it's quite evident that the kind of force that he is willing to use is not going to resolve the issue. And to resolve the issue, we'll have to use much more force, including eventually boots on the ground. And even Senator McCain says he doesn't want that.
Dr. Zbigniew Brzezinski, we thank you very much. It's good
thank
to
you.
Have you with us.
Nice to be with you.